Hey guys, Level Cap here, and today in gaming, we're taking a look at Halo Infinite Multiplayer being free to play, a big improvement to GeForce Now, two new weapons for Modern Warfare, and more. Now, according to an online retailer's listing for Halo Infinite's multiplayer, it will be free to play and run at 120 FPS on the Xbox Series X. And while retailers often get fine details like this wrong, the story has since been confirmed by multiple sources, including industry insiders known for covering the Xbox brand. Details regarding the multiplayer include plans for a battle pass, new customization options, and the return of Arena, aka the classic Halo multiplayer experience. 120 FPS support might not apply to larger scale modes, but it should work with traditional arena modes. Halo Infinite is currently set to debut during the 2020 holiday season alongside the Xbox Series X. A recent demo of the game's campaign left many wondering if the game would truly be a next generation title or not. Issues with the game's lighting, draw distance, enemy models, and more were noted as not being up to the standard of quality expected from a first party next gen title like Halo. In response to the backlash, 343 have pledged to consider the feedback and will continue working to improve the game's detail, clarity, and overall fidelity. A multiplayer reveal is likely in the works for release in the near future, but that could be weeks or even months away. NVIDIA's game streaming service, GeForce Now, has been updated with a new feature that automatically syncs your Steam library. Before this update, users had to manually find and add their Steam games on the GeForce Now store. It was an extra step that left many users confused about what games supported the streaming service and what games didn't. NVIDIA suffered a big blow to GeForce Now's library after it left its beta phase. Many big-name publishers pulled their games, saying they only licensed their titles for use during the service's beta and not for its retail launch. Since then, NVIDIA made their service opt-in for developers and publishers who promptly allowed their games to be streamed again. The reveal of Call of Duty Season 5 yesterday was just a short teaser trailer, but players have already figured out some details regarding new content coming with the update. Season 5 will include two new weapons, the AN-94 Assault Rifle and the BNT APC-9 SMG. As usual, these weapons will be available through the game's Battle Pass, with additional weapons being added in mid-season update that require completing challenges to unlock. Season 5 starts on August 5th. In the meantime, Infinity Ward have enabled double XP for the weekend, including double Battle Pass XP. In our final story today, Warner Brothers are looking to sell off their game development business. Multiple reports have confirmed that Warner Brothers Interactive, which owns Rocksteady, Avalanche Software, NetherRealm, and more, is on the chopping block with many big-name publishers looking to scoop it up. One of those publishers is Electronic Arts. EA's COO revealed during the quarterly investor call that they would be open to acquiring any studios with lots of talent. Warner Brothers Interactive Studios have collectively released some very high-profile titles, including the Batman Arkham franchise and Mortal Kombat. Microsoft was also rumored to be in talks with Warner Brothers, but it doesn't seem like anyone has put a bid in just yet. And that wraps it up for today in gaming. Be sure to hit the playlist at the end of the video to catch up on any stories you might have missed this week, and tune in to tomorrow's episode of This Week in Gaming for a complete recap on all the big stories. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. This is Level Cap signing off.